Hi everyone, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. Besides the usual LEGO reviews, you occasionally see some interesting machines popping up on this channel. We had 3D printers, laser engravers, 3D scanners, and with each of them I tried to figure out what they can actually do for a LEGO fan. Well, today's machine might be the most interesting and definitely the most challenging so far. Makera reached out to me and asked if I could do something cool with their Carvera Air desktop CNC. Yes, I know, everyone wants to see metal parts for LEGO builds, believe me, that was my plan too. But we will start with smaller steps first, show some sample projects to give you an idea of what the machine can do, and of course I will still do something LEGO related today that I hope you will like. A quick disclaimer before we jump in, this is not a full product review. I have some CNC experience, but not much on the design side. I did try a basic CNC a while ago, but that collaboration fizzled out, so there was no content in the end. So, this gigantic box arrived in my workshop. Unboxing it was a real challenge. The machine alone weighs about 35 kilograms, and there are tons of accessories included. Most of the accessories are neatly stored inside the machine itself, which is actually a very smart idea. We get a full toolkit with all the bits for milling, the accessory kit with safety gear and extras, the material sample kit with a bunch of goodies, the fourth axis, which will be a challenge on its own, and the laser module because, surprisingly, this thing can also laser engrave. I won't bore you with the specs, if you are curious, there's a link in the description. Makera is also running a Black Friday sale until the end of the month, so feel free to check it out. Here's the toolkit we will use most of the time. There's not much assembly needed, the magnetic dust shoe snaps in place automatically, and the air assist tube needs to be connected, that's pretty much all. I turned the device on, it came alive, and I chose USB for the connection, I know, I'm old school. It can also connect via Wi-Fi, and there's even a phone/tablet mode with a built-in holder. I selected the appropriate COM port, and we were online. The machine includes a few sample projects. There's an LED light where you can machine the PCB, the base, even the switch, but that will take too long to demo. There's also a 3-axis relief project using epoxy tooling board, so let's try that one. First, we secure the wasteboard and the epoxy board on the table with the included brackets and clamps. We use 2 bits for this project, marked as 1 and 2. Handle them carefully, the first one looks innocent, but the second has a protective sleeve for a reason. Changing tools is very straightforward. Pull the big lever on the side, the bit pops out, insert the new one, release the lever, done. Same for the wired Z-probe. The sample file is preloaded on the machine. I can preview and simulate the toolpath first. After a bit of configuration based on the instructions, I close the lid and hit start. First, I need to confirm that the probe is installed. Then the probe sequence starts, it touches the corner, outlines the work area, then checks the material height. Then it asks for 2-1, easy, and we are good to go. I will admit, I was a bit nervous. But it works. You can follow the toolpath live on the screen while the machine does its job. I didn't install the dust shoe yet, because I need to upgrade the vacuum adapter, the machine will definitely not stay spotless for long. Second layer started, let's fast forward a bit. This is much messier than 3D printing for sure. I paused to clean up a bit and check the result. Still not recognizable, but we are on the right track. Now tool 2 goes in, and the party continues. I had no idea how long this would take. Based on the first pass, I thought it would be quick, but nope. The app display is wrong though. It says 1 hour in with almost 2 more to go. The estimated time left was going up faster than the elapsed time. We switch back to tool 1 for a short finishing pass, and finally, we are done. Cleanup time, and here it is, our 3D pirate ship. Still attached to the frame, needs cutting out, but looks great. Next test, the fourth axis. I won't show the full installation, it was straightforward following the guide. We use similar material, load the file, adjust the parameters, 2 files this time, starting with the roughing pass. I can see where the actual work will happen, and after probing, it is time to go. After roughing, tons of cleanup, then refinement. And the final result looks very impressive, lots of fine detail. The ends still need trimming, but I did not expect this level of resolution. Before the custom test, I 3D printed this adapter for my vacuum so I could test the dust shoe. Adapter goes in, hose connected, time to make something of our own. The Carvera controller can only control the machine. For designing, you need a separate CAD/CAM software. This is Makera Cam, made specifically for the Carvera. It has the tools and materials built in, so it's pretty beginner friendly. I imported the RacingBrick logo, what else, and I will carve it in two layers into the second epoxy board. File loaded, probing done, and the roughing pass goes surprisingly quickly. Then the fine tool adds all the sharp details, looking great so far. Layer 2, two stages again, and here's the finished result. I really like this one. Now it's finally Lego time. I grabbed this red Technic panel and tried engraving the extended RacingBrick logo. I struggled with laser engraving Lego previously, lots of dangerous fumes with diode lasers, IR was a bit better but still risky, and the plastic melted a lot of times. This time I cut 0.1mm deep, alignment was a bit off, but the result is very promising. Next, a dark bleach grey panel with 0.3mm depth. This looks seriously cool. Needs cleanup and the panel grooves interrupt the pattern, but on a smooth surface it would look fantastic. Well, here's the same pattern on a flat surface at 0.2mm, looks awesome. You can also trace bitmap graphics in the software. Adjust a few parameters, run it, and again, a very nice result. Air assist would help, I don't have a proper pump yet, but next time. And finally, the same pattern on a UCS plug, this looks way better than the laser engraved version. If you want to engrave Lego, you will have way better results with a CNC. I even did a little experiment, painted the grooves and wiped the excess. Can be improved, but I like the effect, definitely something to explore more. So folks, that was my first adventure with the Carvera Air Desktop CNC. This is a serious machine with a huge potential, but also a steeper learning curve than a 3D printer. You need to know what you are doing, especially with all these tools. I'm heading back to the tutorials to learn how to handle real 3D objects, and I can't wait to put these aluminum blocks in the machine. Meanwhile, let me know what LEGO compatible parts you would like to see next. Gears, wheel covers, maybe an axle if I can make it work. Share your ideas, but be realistic please, I'm still learning. And if you are a CNC expert, I would be happy for some hints. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe with notifications as more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye.